What's up? It's your girl Jupiter, Pink Alchemist here, bringing you the general reading for the sign of Taurus and their soulmate for October 2018. Now, these readings are very general. The energies are very general and interchangeable, so it may or may not resonate. Take what does, leave the rest, or leave it all, or use it as entertainment purposes, whatever works for you. You know, I hope everybody's doing good. I hope everybody's loving themselves. I do ask y'all forgive me. I do have a cold that I'm getting over. This first song is How You Gonna Act Like That by Tyrese. Okay. I don't really remember this song all like that, but I'm just going to use the title as being self-explanatory. How you gonna act like that? How you gonna act like that, boo? How you gonna act like that? How you gonna act like I wasn't a shit to you? Let me hold up, y'all. Let me not guess this shit. Let me see what he actually talking about. Making up, don't change it up. How you gonna act like that? How you gonna act like we won't be making love, tearing the sheets up, tearing the bed up? How you gonna act like we won't have a great time? It's just PG-13 that. How you gonna act like we don't have an awesome time together, okay? How are you gonna act like you don't love me and you don't care about me and we don't make the best peanut butter and jellies together? My gosh. How you gonna act like that? How? How you gonna act like you don't love my loving? Anyways, somebody acting like they brand new and somebody wanna know why you acting like that. Taurus soulmate, who knows? Soulmate energy be crazy. Y'all give me 10 seconds real quick. Sorry about that. Okay, so I have prayed and shuffled and cleansed my deck. So I'm gonna flip these cards. All right, soulmate for Taurus. Taurus, I hope you guys are being good to yourself, being y'all's positive affirmations, loving yourself, putting yourselves first. Taurus like to think about everybody but themselves sometimes, and it's very honorable, but it can also be a lot on them to not give back to themselves. And people can get very used to not giving shit to them, because I don't know why people tend to think if you got it, you good. Like, oh, they got it. Taurus got it. They good. Oh, Taurus got it. He good. She good. Taurus don't need no. You'll never be able to see a Taurus sweat. So it's like, they good. They good. They don't feel like the rest of us. But it's like, dawg, you guys are the most loving sign there is. Like, you deserve love. You deserve someone to tell you that you're doing an awesome job. Someone to tell you that you are the shit. I know Tauruses do think that they are the shit, you know, usually. But it's like they're very under, like they're taken for granted a lot of times because of the type of love that the type of strength that they possess. So anyways, getting to this reading. The first card is, and I have pulled these cards a few times in y'all's spread, which is, you know, this energy really wants to make sure I get y'all's energy across. So, Ace of Spades is the, hold up. Because this is a commercial playing. and I don't like these commercials. This is R. Kelly Ignition remix. Somebody wants to put the key in your ignition. I don't know. Let's not pay too much attention to that. We all know R. Kelly a fool. So anyways, we got the Ace of Spades. So this is an attempt to reconcile. This is somebody seeing the facts in the situation. They're having revelations, they're realizing some shit. They're fully aware of the facts. They're fully aware of the facts in the situation. This also represents a door that's been closed and another one that's being opened. So somebody could be trying to reconcile a situation or fix a situation that they're just now having revelations about. They're just now realizing, like, oh, light bulb. Damn. So let's see what's going on. Somebody realized some shit. So with the king, with the King of Spades, it talks about someone who, a professional person who are fair. They're a fair person. They come off as a judge in some types of situations. They have rational viewpoints. They're able to balance out things. They're able to see the facts and balance out the truth in a situation. I feel like, because the King of Spades also represents our swords energy, which is our air. So this to me is always somebody, this is the ultimate cutoff person, the person who is cutting shit out their life left and right. Why? Because they bring fair judgment. They look at the logic. They're able to look at the logic and spiritual side of things and weigh it out to where it is, you know, where it makes sense to them to see the facts in it. Like they see the facts in it. They're able to weigh it out to see the facts in it and make a just decision. Most likely cutting that shit about their life, because the King of Swords to me, or King of Spades to me, is about that, cutting that shit out. So with the Queen of Spades sitting right next to it, these are people right here. These represent people. So with the Queen of Swords, it's about someone having a past pain, someone who's intelligent with their ideas. They're very intellectual. They're a firm person. They're also a truth seeker. And once again, that justice, that ability to be fair and to weigh out some shit real quick. This is Always on Time by Ja Rule. Somebody saying, I'm not always there when you call, but I'm always on time. I gave you my all, now be mine. He's saying, you know the game, love is about pain. Something so real. Who cares what anybody else think? Somebody feel like they gave somebody their all and they want them to be theirs. Or they want to give their all to somebody and they want them to be theirs. And real love is going to come with some real ass pain attached to it, apparently. So with the king and the queen of spades, of that swords energy, These are two people that I feel like, and this could represent Taurus, but I feel like this is representing Taurus and whoever Taurus is dealing with. They're both leveled out on the same playing field. They both are willing or able to cut shit up out their life, to make fair judgment on situations. They both could be wanting to reconcile. They both may have had revelations. Taurus, you could be dealing with an air sign. This is definitely somebody all in their head thinking about a situation that needs judgment, that needs a fair, just call, or they have recently made a fair, just call on it and just had that revelation or that truth to want to come towards this person. The king is looking for their queen. The king is trying to get with their queen and match up. Like, this is some shit, y'all. This is some shit. So anyways, with the Ten of Hearts, excuse me, sorry guys. With the Ten of Hearts, it talks about family, love, achievements, an emotional peak of goodness, coming together, a celebration. So, like I said, yeah, somebody wants to come together with their queen. A queen wants to come together with their king. They are mirroring each other perfectly. It's like they both had the revelation at the same time. Okay, so yeah, okay. This is a divine partnership right here. Because there's a mirroring energy that is like on point. And these two people are on the same page in life right now. This is a divinely guided relationship with divine. This is a soulmate reading for real. This bitch, damn. So anyways, somebody's looking to come together with love. They really have that celebration. They're ready to have that celebration. They're ready to be in love with somebody. They're feeling complete. They're ready to share their love. They have stability. They have purity, happiness, emotional maturity. They've reached a level of maturity in their heart. Hold up. Oh, okay. This is Bad Remix, Wale, Rihanna. Somebody like, I had some issues in the past. I admit it, but I'm gonna be bad. I wanna be bad to you. Not in the bad way. I wanna be the good bad to you. I wanna be the bad good to you. And like, I've always been a fuck nigga or a fuck bitch to other people in my life, but I wanna be all that I need to be for you. I'm ready to come together with somebody and I wanna be bad for them. This person wanna be in bed with a motherfucker. They wanna lay with somebody. They want to love them all over. Like, I wanna come together. I wanna make you my wife. I want to have that home life together where I can have you every night, every day, every morning. It's just me and you. We're perfect. You're me and I'm you. So anyways, with the Six of Hearts, this is somebody being and having nostalgic memories. You could have known this person in your childhood. Y'all could be childlike together. This person, y'all's energy together could be that of like that have like this adolescent, this youthful sense to it. You guys reflecting each other's goofiness, reflecting each other's laughters. Like, when you laugh, I laugh. That shit's funny. We're the same person. We laughing at the same shit. We find the same shit funny.
Somebody thinking about the past real tough.
Yeah, so this is somebody who having a revelation. They had a revelation about a soulmate union, somebody, a partnership that they were in or had. These people may not be talking to each other right now, because in order to have this mirroring effect happen the way it is, hold up. Okay, so in order to have this mirroring effect like this, these people had to separate. They had to separate and live their life and like figure shit out on their own terms. I mean, I guess they could be talking, but very little contact or... No. Fuck that. These are two motherfuckers that ain't talking to each other. Sorry, guys. This is that soulmate. This is that divine partnership. People like to call it twin flame. If you know anything about twin flame relationship, then you know that shit is a rough road to travel, honey. It's a rough road to travel. People who are on that journey don't want to be on that journey no more. They are happy of the blessings that they receive from it, but it's like, shit. At some point, everybody's grateful for the union, for the twin flame connection. But at some point, motherfuckers be ready to bow the fuck out. Like, look, I ain't signed up for this shit. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. But it be so hard at some moments in their life that they feel like, you know what, this person, I can't. I'm loving this person so much that I can't be myself around them. And I don't know why. It's like the polarity switch. It's like the person who had the masculine energy all their life are now feminine. And the person who had the feminine energy all their life are now masculine. So these two people are now balanced out. To have these cards right next to each other, these people are balanced out like a motherfucker. They're even yoked for real. They both had a realization. They both had facts come up that they see, like, damn, clarity. This person is the one. This person mimics me, mirrors me in every way. This person is who I want to be with. They're who I want to come into union with. They're who I want to marry and wake up to every day and smell their funky ass breath. Whatever it is, I want to be with this person. I'm daydreaming about it. I'm thinking about it. I'm being nostalgic about every moment that we've had. I'm in my head about it. I'm thinking about it. I'm thinking all the time. This person can't get you out their mind. You can't get that person out of your mind. That's why you're here listening to me, boo. Thank you. But yeah, that's what's up. I hope this resonates with somebody. I really do. Okay, so the last song, I had to turn down too low, but it's Shawty Is the Shit by The Dream. That's self-explanatory. Yeah. Somebody feel like you the shit. You probably feel like they the shit. Whoever was the runner in a situation is definitely looking at it like, you know, they was the shit. Facts. So I hope this resonates with somebody. Somebody shit, I hope y'all can't hear my stomach growling. Shit, I can't hear over this motherfucker right now. But I hope this resonates with somebody. Please comment, like, share, subscribe. I appreciate all of y'all's time. Taurus, y'all show me a lot of love for September. Y'all stand up for your bid in October. Thank you so much. And I love y'all. Y'all continue to be y'all's positive affirmations. Enjoy life, love life. If this is somebody, I don't know, I can't tell you to go towards this person if you're the runner. I can't tell you to go towards this person if you were considered the chaser, the feminine energy or the masculine energy. Do what works for you. Y'all know what the facts are, though. Y'all know what type of new beginning y'all want with a motherfucker. So do what it is that resonates the best with you. I gotta go, you guys. I love y'all. Take care. See y'all soon.